When people bring home a new puppy or dog, the first thing that they usually teach is the sit. There's a specific way of giving the sit cue that optimizes obedience later. The most important thing to remember is that when you give the cue to sit, you also have to remember to release your dog from the sit. If you simply give him the cue but never release him, then he might sit for just a moment and then move on to something else that he'd rather be doing. When you teach the sit, the stay is assumed. So the dog should hold the position until cued to do otherwise. So whenever we give the cue to sit or down, there's three steps that we want to remember. The cue, the marker, which is the click or the word yes, and the release from the sit. So don't forget the cue, the mark, and the release. So in order to teach the sit, we're going to use first our hand signal. Our hand signal for the sit is the palm up action, but the palm up towards the dog's rear. So in order to teach that hand signal, we're going to mimic that for our luring action. So we start by holding the treat between our first finger and our thumb, allow the dog to taste the treat, and pull the treat back over his head towards his rear end as he follows the treat into a sit. The moment the dog's bum hits the floor, you click and then offer the release cue. The release cue is to tap your leg and turn sideways to coax the dog to get up. The biggest mistake that people make when they're asking for a sit is to change the hand signal or cue every time they give the cue to the dog. Some people say sit, sit, sit. Some people switch from hand signal to pointing to pushing the dog's bum on the floor to pulling on the dog's collar into a sit. This is very confusing for your dog, so it's very, very important to be consistent with your hand signal or verbal cue. Always use the same hand signal, palm up, or the verbal cue one time, sit. If you give the verbal cue once and your dog does not respond, don't repeat yourself. Simply follow through with the hand signal.